Hello. Today we're going to draw the Northern Lights. So I've got my purple. Let's see. Or violet. Violet works. I'm going to start with my horizon. A little straight line here. Straightish. Make it a little darker. And I'm going to put in mountains. So lots of upside down V's. There we go. So we've got our mountains. I'm going to add in little highlight spots on our mountains. I'm just kind of showing which parts of the mountains get a lot of light on them. It's like the edges. Nice. I'm going to fill them in with violet color. If you're using markers, you can get stuff, you can get your colors darker by going over the same spot more than once. If you're using pencils, like these colored pencils, or crayons, they work a little differently. You'll get darker color if you press harder, and if you drag it across your paper in more than one direction. So I'm going diagonally here. If I want more dark, come in from the other side and go diagonally as well. And the more directions you scrape the tool on the paper, the darker it'll get, as more of it gets caught on little edges of the paper. All right. And I think this will look really nice on a lake. So I'm going to draw the reflections of the mountains. Like that. And the reflection always looks a little different because it's not perfect. So I'm going to leave a little white space at the horizon. I'm going to leave the reflections a lighter color. Nice. All right. Now for the lights themselves. They're ribbons of color that show up when, I think it's ionized particles from the sun, interact with the Earth's magnetic field. So it makes ribbons of bright, colorful light. I'm just going to draw the ribbons. Nice and loose. You can start with any color you like. So now I'm going to go in, kind of stretch the ribbon towards the top of my paper, adding color on top of it. Now, normally you can only see these near the north or the south pole. I've never seen one, but I'd like to. Maybe you'll get to see one someday. If you do, I'd love to hear about it. Sometimes my hand hurts from drawing a lot. And the way that I was taught to stop my hand from hurting is to pretend I hold a little something here with these fingertips. Keeping those tucked in helps stop my hand from hurting. Like that. Nice. So, I'm thinking about the rainbow. It's red, orange, yellow, green. So I've got my green, but I don't want to do blue, because I'm going to use blue for the sky. So we'll go the other direction. So green, yellow, orange, red. So I'm going to add yellow ribbon on top of the green ribbon. And I overlap the two to mix the colors. And I bring the yellow a little taller than the green, so it has some part of the ribbon that's just yellow. Now, yellow with markers is tough because yellow ink is really see-through. It's really transparent. So it may not mix too well. It may just look like green or really dark. That's okay. Move these up top. Now come back. Nice. Orange. We do the same thing, but above the yellow, adding to its ribbon, and overlapping the yellow a little bit. Right, our last color, red. Oh, I'm running out of space up there. That's okay. Now we're almost done. Now we just got to do the reflection. So I'm looking at the line in green that I made. I just try and get as close as I can. Nice. Instead of doing the full stripes, set my pencil on the side, do little stripes. This is a little faster. And make sure the reflection looks different than the real thing. now I gotta find a blue, finish up our sky, then we're all done. And there's our Northern Lights. Thanks for drawing with me. I'll be seeing you next time.